Please attention. This tutorial is only for those who want to upgrade from HDRi Maker 2.0 series to HDRi Maker 3.0 series. If you are a new user, follow the other video, how to install. Go to your Blender Market order page or Gumroad library page. To upgrade the add-on, download the file name starting with HDRi_Maker_V, where the V stands for version and the numbers are the version. If you are a Macintosh user and are using Safari, be aware that Safari automatically decompresses the zip files, so take 1 minute more time, and use Mozilla Firefox or Google Chrome to download your zip files. The add-on must be in zip format like this. First of all, let's uninstall only the older version of HDRi Maker 2.0 series, but don't remove the libraries. Keep them on your computer for later. Delete the add-on from Blender by pressing the Remove button. Press Install. Select the previously downloaded zip add-on. Now let's activate the add-on. Press Save Preferences if you don't have autosave set on it. Restart Blender. Now, pressing this button, search on your computer, where the library default library of HDRi Maker version 2.0 are located. In the path below, we enter the path to the user library folder. We are almost ready to convert them to the new libraries for HDRi Maker 3.0. We will convert both the default library and the user library. Select a path where you want the library to be converted. Do the same with the user library. Press Convert. The conversion process transforms the old library into the new one. The old library is kept on disk. If you want to delete it, you can do it later. If all goes well, a green check appears on the button. I also convert the old user library. Please note, if your user library is empty, because you have never saved backgrounds in it, you can leave it empty and press the Make User Library button. Now your old libraries have been converted. In the old library, the backgrounds only went up to 8K. You can now download 16K versions from your downloads page as well. Make sure you also download the main library volume 1. Save your downloaded files anywhere on your computer. They are used to install the libraries that you are missing. If you are not sure, you can also not download anything. Later, through HDRi Maker, you can check which volumes you are missing to install. You'll find out how to do it later in the video. The volumes are named with the content format. In this case, we are interested in 16K formats. With the release of HDRi Maker 3.0, there are more than 100 backgrounds in the new HDR Maps expansion. You can download them now or later. Now, if you have downloaded the library volumes in Exapack format, you can proceed to install them. Press the Options button. Press the Install tab. Press the Choose Exapacks button. Look for the folder where you downloaded the Exapack format files. Select the packs you want to install. In this case, I install the 16K ones that weren't present in the previous version. Now all the packages you want to install are listed. By default, the add-on removes Exapack packages as soon as they are installed. This is useful for saving a lot of space. If you want to keep them on your computer, simply mark the Keep Exapack after install checkbox. Press Install from Exapack Files button. The speed of the installation process depends on the speed of the disk in use. You can also stop it and resume it later. To do this, you can press the button on the right side of the large progress bar at the top. During the installation, we can already see that some versions of the 16K backgrounds are present in the HDRi Maker library. Under the Updates tab, you can also check how many libraries you have installed and which ones you are missing. In the right column, you will see the packages that have been installed. In the left column, those that are not installed are shown. Those marked in green are those installed. Thanks for watching.